in this video, I'm gonna show you a special little trick that you can do out of the gun bunch formation that almost every pro player knows and uses it to be able to destroy the meta defense in Madden 22, which is 30-yard Mabel coverages where they have 30-yard cloud flats, 5-yard curl flats, and 5-yard hook curls. Now, if you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe. I upload new videos every single day. I also wanna let you know that if you wanna learn my entire gun bunch offensive guide, I did a guide this year that covered every single gun bunch from multiple different playbooks. So it was Seattle, Washington, Carolina, and more. So if you want to get that ebook, there's a link in the description below where you can get access to it. So if you want to get the ebook, check it out. But also wanted to talk to you today about this concept. So what we're going to do, honestly, you don't really need to come out in anything. You can come out in whatever play you want. Personally, I personally prefer to come out in something like clear out, SE out. The reason why is because I like that stock fade. So I'm going to come out in that play. But what we want to do is we want to flip our bunch and we want to come out in the play with our bunch to the short side of the field. Because what we want to do is we want to leverage all of the field, all of the space that we can get to the wide side. So we're going to come out in the play clear out, SE out to the short side of the field. This is in the Seattle Seahawks playbook, and it's my personal favorite play in the gun bunch. So clear out, SE out. And then all we're going to do from an adjustments perspective is we are going to put Mike Evans. We're going to hot route him to a crossing route. Now, you can do this if you have Hot Route Master. You can also do this if you have Slot Apprentice. And then what we're going to do is we're just going to flip our play. And what I like to do personally is just slide my line to the right and block my tight end. I actually typically will leave this option route. If you don't want to do that, then you can feel free to just put him on a hitch. If you don't have the play clear out, SE out in your playbook, what you can also do is you could just simply put him on a streak or a fade and put R1 on a hitch. So I'm going to show it to you this way first, and then we'll cover the other alternate setup in just a moment. But what you're going to see here, snap the ball. We're going to get great pass protection. We're just going to slide to the pocket here, and I'm going to pass lead that up. And as you can see, this is going to get to about the opposing team's 40-yard line. So from where I'm standing on the 20-yard line of the field, it's going to be about a 40-yard dot over the top. Now, the cool part about this is you can actually do this regardless, and I'll show you what I'm talking about here. So I'm going to show you kind of the alternate setup. So now what we could do is, so let's say we have our bunch to the wide side of the field. We can put Antonio Brown on the crosser, flip our play, put Mike Evans on a fade, put Godwin on a hitch, and block our tight end. So you see this is what the play looks like. And at the snap of the ball, now you're going to see this crosser. If you look at where it's at on the field, if I pass like that up, see how it's going to get about the same distance, maybe even a little deeper. This is one of my favorite little setups. And the reason why is because the user basically has to run with the crosser the entire duration of the play. Because the other thing that you could do with this is a version of a 5-out setup. So let's say you're facing a lot of send 3 backed off coverage out of a Mabel look where they're really not sending a lot of pressure. Okay. So what we're going to do now, put Mike Evans on that crossing route. We're going to flip our play. And then this is actually a really cool little setup. We're going to take Bernard and put him on a wheel route. And then what we're going to do is we're still going to streak R1. But now what we're going to do with our tight end on this play is we're actually going to take him and put him on a 5-yard little check down in route. And then we're going to take Brown and we're going to put him on a slant. What I like to do what this is for is to kind of try to pull their user to the left side of the field. If they don't go to the left side of the field, we're going to get somebody open. But if they do, then obviously our crosser is going to get open just as long as we have enough time in the pocket. So you see here, all of the routes go together. And then as you can see, this crosser dot over the top for an easy gain. So this is truly one of my favorite plays. It's very good against match defense. And again, you could do this out of any play. A lot of you guys have the gun bunch verticals play in your audibles. This is a great setup for that. And the reason why is because we can really capitalize on this motioned out wheel as kind of a deep read, and then we have this kind of running back check down. I really like this because you go ahead and block your tight end. Now you've got a good cover 2 beater out of that, and then you've got that crosser that's going to come over here on that side. So those are some simple ways that you can utilize this setup. Again, there is so much more that we could talk about. One of my other favorite ways to run this is you could actually go ahead and you could you know, run a little bit of a mesh concept. And this is one of my favorites. So we could put the back on a in route, put square on a streak, and then just block the tight end. This setup right here is probably my favorite play in the game from Gun Bunch. And the reason why is because I've got that nice meshing concept, and then I've got this coming right over the top to absolutely obliterate any Mabel coverage that they might want to do. So try this setup out. I'm telling you, if you've never used Slot Apprentice in your Gun Bunch or Hot Route Master, it really does take the whole offense to an entirely new level. So I would really encourage you to try it out. Thanks for watching this video, guys. And if you want to get instant access to every ebook that I've released so far in the Madden 22 season, so far I've released this Gun Bunch ebook, but I've also released 12 other additional guides, 8 on defense, 5 of them on offense, for a total of 13 ebooks. You can get immediate access to them by joining our Patreon membership. My Patreon membership is just 10 bucks a month, and you can cancel whenever you like. But by joining the Patreon membership, you're going to get instant access to every guide that I've already released. And you're also going to get instant access to every guide that I am going to release in the future. The other thing that's really cool about the Patreon is, as different patches come out, as we find new setups, we tend to update some of our guides. So you always have the most up-to-date version of the offense or defense that we're breaking down. So I would really encourage you, if you've not joined the Patreon yet, to be sure to do that. There's a link in the description below where you can join. And again, it's just 10 bucks a month, and then you can cancel whenever you want. So you don't have to sign up for a year or anything. But again, thanks for your support. I hope you enjoyed the video. And if you want to get access to all that stuff, make sure to join the Patreon. There is a link to do that in the description.